response to sources telling CNN that Cohen says that President Trump did know in advance about that infamous Trump Tower meeting with Russians. The president has just tweeted, "I did not know of the meeting with my son, Don Jr. Sounds to me like someone is trying to make up stories in order to get himself out of an unrelated jam. Taxi cabs, maybe, hint, hint. He even retained Bill and Crooked Hillary's lawyer. Gee, I wonder if they helped him make that choice." Joining us now is Ian Bremmer. He's the president of the Eurasia Group and author of Us Versus Them, The Failure of Globalism. So, Ian, we need the big picture of this, okay? So everything, it seems to me that since the Helsinki summit, a lot has changed. A lot has come out. There's been breaking news on our watch every single morning. Can you imagine if you were Michael Cohen, okay, the president's longtime devoted servant, and you watched that Helsinki summit where Donald Trump seemed to defend or support Vladimir Putin more than he ever has since Michael Cohen got in trouble. And now Michael Cohen is speaking, or at least, he's speaking publicly through his attorneys.
Somebody. Yeah.
Through somebody.
There's a lot of grist for the mill, but you asked me about the big picture.
Yeah.
So you really want the big picture?
Yeah.
This has been a good week for Trump.
Wow.
I mean, look, we get out of CNN land for just a second.
Give it to us.
And 4% growth in the United States. The Europeans back down on trade. He now looks like a winner on that front. The North Koreans, more progress with remains coming back. And stuff about Michael Cohen, I mean, is he credible? He was Trump's lawyer. If you are a Trump supporter, this is just blah, blah, blah. Now, the Helsinki stuff was really bad for Trump, and he had to walk it back. And the Republicans were hitting him pretty hard for a day. And now he's basically said, okay, I'm not going to do the summit this year after all. I'm not going to recognize Crimea as a part of Russia. Nothing actually happened. We don't know what was in the two-hour private conversation. It's really weird. We'll talk about that a lot, but nobody else is going to. So, I mean, seriously, this has been a good week for Trump.
Let's continue this train of thought here, because I think it's fascinating. One of the things you do so people know is assess risk.
Yeah.
What is the biggest risk?